what surrounds the solar system? Planets.
It's always fun to work with kids, especially when they're as enthusiastic as this group was.
Did anybody have anything else that they'd like to add?
Now, you heard about how upstairs we don't destroy anything using XRF? Down here we get to destroy it all.
Yay!
I think one of the most important things we do as scientists is try to spread love of science to the kids.
And every element, such as lead, effectively has a different type of sun with a different number of what are called protons and neutrons.
You're gonna send these elements, right? Like these elements, lead or whatever we're shooting for, right? And we nuke them, like we heat them really hot as the sun.
I think most kids are pretty aware that what they're seeing on TV probably isn't what really happens. More often than not, I think, in my experience, I've seen that kids tend to be surprised that it's as close to TV at times as it gets.
So this is just a huge hot flame.
Any of you guys thrown up before?
Yes.
Yeah? You notice how your throat has burned? Yeah. That throat burning is due to your stomach acid.
So we took our piece of plumbing, right? Weighed it out, we digested it, we got this glorious blue color on our solution, which is always fun to look at. It
takes quite a bit of time to bounce back and forth between am I putting too much science in that's above their heads versus am I not putting enough science in. So it's a real back and forth in deciding how much information to give and how much fun to make it for the kids. I mean, obviously, the science we see on television isn't very accurate for the most part, but the look of the science is a lot like the look you see in a real lab. And so when the kids get to come in and say, yes, there are these big instruments, yes, we do take these colorful samples and put them through the machines, it does give them a little bit of hope for the wonder that's actually available in science.